Hello everyone and welcome back to the Keep Productive YouTube channel. Today's video is going to be with Kehi, who is running Rad Reads. He has been here on the channel before and it's great to have him back. In today's video, he's actually going to do something that may be a little bit specific for people, but he's actually going to show us how he sets up his Notion for collaborating with a virtual assistant. Now, when it comes to collaborating with a VA, it sometimes can be a little bit tricky, but he shows you how he can set up a workspace that takes advantage of Notion's features and the collaborative abilities. So I hope this one is useful. It might be useful not just for a virtual assistant, but for someone that you work with quite closely or administration-based work, it might also apply. Now, before we begin, Kehi's actually got a whole course, the cohort 4, that is coming out, and you can find the link to the course in the description below. Also, he has a YouTube channel. If you haven't checked it out yet, I highly recommend it. He dives into everything about Notion, finance, and lots more. So without further ado, I'll pass you over to Kehi.
Hello, Francesco and the Keep Productive family. Thank you so much for having me back on your channel. For those of you who don't know me, my name is Kehi. I'm the creator of the blog and newsletter Rad Reads, and I teach the popular Notion course, Supercharge Your Productivity. Today, I want to tell you about a dynamic duo, one that has freed up tons of time, improved our product, and reduced the unnecessary communication friction that comes with Slack. I'm going to show you how I collaborate with my VA, my virtual assistant, using Notion for projects and task management. First, I'll begin by showing you how we use primary tables and templates to standardize and streamline everything that we do. Then I'll give you a real life example about how I write one of my 3 weekly newsletters without stepping foot in my email software. I hope you enjoy the tutorial. We will begin as usual with a blank Notion page. And since the company is called Rad Reads, we'll start with a Rad HQ and we'll just slap on a little icon just to get things going. So I use the lightning bolt. Now, for all of our communications with my virtual assistant, my VA, we'll go through 2 primary tables. I'm a big advocate of having a very minimalist setup. And so let us create these 2 tables. The first table is going to be a table of notes. And so we'll call this primary notes. And here we'll have, this will be kind of like our file explorer. And so here we'll change this to note type. And we can have a few different note types. We're gonna really focus on the SOP, which is the standard operating procedure, but we could have a brainstorm. We can have an active note. And then we can have a reference note. All right, and I'll just go in and just do some little formatting. I'll unwrap the cells, and then I'm gonna make this a wide screen just so it airs things out. Okay, so this will be our notes table. And again, we'll create a bunch of different notes and they can have these different types. I'm gonna go in and just delete this column. Now, our second table will be a tasks table. And in our task table, we will then, we'll create it and it will be a table, another inline table, and this will be primary tasks. And so we'll change this to task. And we'll just create this very simple columns for a task list, whether the task is done or not. We'll then put in a due date, which is a date type. And then we will put in an assignee, assigned to, because as you know, we'll be assigning this to a person and this will be a person type. All right, so there you have it. We have a series of tasks and a series of notes. Now, this is where it starts to get really interesting because in the notes, we want to create a note template. And so how are we going to do that? We're going to go in and hit this little blue arrow here, and it gives you this option for a new template. I click new template, and then you'll see this tan bar here. And so I'll just write this right here, new SOP. Now, again, this is not a specific page or a note. This is just a template. And so in this template, we will basically pre-populate what our SOPs or our standing operating procedures look like. So the first thing I'll do is I will put in, I like to do a call out. So the call out will be a vision. SOP vision. So this is, why are we even doing this in the first place? The next thing we'll put in are resources required. That way the person reading this, my VA, knows resource one, resource two, which resources are required. The third thing we'll put in, and I'm using headers here, will be step-by-step instructions. And these will be a mix of screenshots, clicks, Loom videos, and notes. All right. So then we have, so that's step-by-step instructions. Next, we will have task inputs. And this will be really important because it, as we create the new task, it will crystallize what information needs to get passed from the task assigner, which is me, to the task assignee, which is my VA. And so here it could look like subject line, I'm using this just as an example, placeholder. And then you could have opening paragraph followed by a placeholder. All right. So these are the variables, the inputs that will be passed along as we create a new task. And then lastly, very important, the definition of done. And this is almost like a post production checklist. So we just put a few of these lazy checkboxes. Action one, action two. All right. So we have crystallized what our SOPs would look like. So I click out here and then you'll see, let me just delete this row. You'll see that if I wanted to go into my notes, anyone on our team, and we wanted to create a new SOP, we would just go in here. And you'll see it's populating. This would be a note type SOP. And this could be create a Tuesday newsletter. And then we could go in and fill out all of, you know, this is how we share our jobs with our community. And again, this is the SOP, the standard operating procedure, so it just lives once. And then we could put in the resources here, and I'll show you a real life example, ConvertKit. We would write out all the instructions in this section. I'm not gonna do that in this video. And then we would pass the inputs. Again, you'll see this all in action. Here is the RAD HQ. Now, I spent all my day in this screen where it's my command center. And so I wanna take the theory that we just discussed and show it to you in practice. Now, the first thing I wanna show you is that we have aggregated all of our SOPs. And so as you scroll through here, everything we do is memorialized. And so here is the updating the RAD jobs. That's our Tuesday newsletter. So let's open that up. So as you can see here, you have it as a doc type, as an SOP. These are some old links. And here are the different sections. So first you have the vision, then you have the resources required, then you have the step-by-step instructions, including Loom videos, other notes about PDFs, things like that. Then you have the SOP input. So these are the inputs that will get passed along. And then you have the definition of done. Now this is an evergreen document. We update this if there are changes to it, but it lives on, it doesn't change very frequently. All right, so that is our SOP. And like I showed you, there is a whole list of SOPs. So let's go back to our RAD HQ. So these are SOPs, and that was the one that we just worked on. Now let me go and hide them. Now we have the task. So let's say it's Monday and I'm getting ready to assign the task to create that new SOP. I'll go in here and you can see we have all these different templates, but here will be compile Tuesday newsletter. So I click it here. And as you can see, it's assigned. I assigned it just to keep my employees anonymous, but it's assigned to little Kehi. There's a bunch of different metadata here. You see the link to the SOP. And so, as you can see, this is the task that's being assigned. And so I will go in, and this is a job posting email. So I'll go in, and you'll see this is issue 33. So these are all of the jobs we're gonna share in this newsletter, but I might change the filter and make it 35. And you'll see it in the SOP, it says what needs to be done with each of these different jobs. By the way, I can click to the SOP here if I need the person this is assigned to, my VA, needs reference. Then these are the variables. So what's the subject line going to be for this SOP? It might be for this job email. It might be great specialist role at member space. Okay. Now my VA will then use this text as my subject line. So this is K driving right now, and I'm setting things up for my VA. The opening paragraph might say something like, "Hi, hope you had a great week. We've got some great roles in IT sec, security, and crypto." Okay. Now, again, I'm writing air quotes an email that will then that my VA will then do in ConvertKit. So we have a PS at the end of the email, and then second PS. Don't miss our next event on 10/31. Okay. Now these are all going to be passed through the task. Remember, this is a task. And the task is create email for issue 35. It's being assigned to my VA from me. And it has all the links to the necessary information. So then it will show up on our task list. It will be assigned, and we can always, always just go back to it. The quickest way to do that would be to go in and view, we could view all the tasks. And actually in this case, we could just go in and see that old email. Now, this is the best part about this task assignment, because we never need to communicate about this task in Slack. All of the communications gets done through this comment. So make sure to link to the correct event. And then I hit send. And so this reduces the communication friction. It keeps everything tied directly to the task. And as a result, both myself and my VA can spend all of our time in Notion and not have to jump amongst tools. So there you have it. That is how I can create an email newsletter that goes out to 10,000 people without having to open my email software or without having to open Slack.
Thank you so much for watching this tutorial. Never in a million years did I think I could send hundreds of thousands of emails, build a newsletter business, all from Notion with the help of a VA. Now, if you want to dig into more about SOPs or standard operating procedures, you can grab that template that's available in the show notes, and you could always head over to radreads.co to learn more about me, Notion, and how to live your best life. Hope you have a great day, and thank you.